Justin, well, certainly I am no Dana Roselia, but I'm going to do my best here. Johnny Katz from the Review Journal joins us right now.
Right away.
A lot of things going on as normal, including Kendra Wilkinson. She's in town. She's got a great show, right?
Yeah, Kendra Wilkinson and Jay Rodriguez have opened a show called Sex Tips for a Straight Woman from a Gay Man. And it's okay. at the Anthony Cools Theater at Paris, Las Vegas. You can see who's who in this cast.
Yes.
And this is a show that it's an unusual show. It's a stage show with a lot of script. It's a comedy that's very ribald, as the title would, and you'd expect from the title. And Kendra plays a woman named Robin, who's part of a sex author workshop, and Jay is an author who comes out and has her explore uncharted territory.
That's got to be really interesting, huh?
I saw a rehearsal of it. I'll tell you one thing, Todd. There's a lot of script, a lot of book in this show, a lot to memorize for these actors.
Really?
So it's very challenging, especially for Kendra, because she's not really, she's been in reality shows. She was on The Girls Next Door with Holly Madison and Bridget Marquardt, a decade ago at the Playboy Mansion, and she's in her own reality show now, Kendra on top. But this is something, she's an actress, and it's going to be interesting to see how they interact with each other. But they're both very appealing. Jay's very funny. And so that's that just opened, and it's going to run for 12 weeks at Paris, Las Vegas.
Okay. Also understand something new is happening at the lounge at the Palms, so to speak, here.
Yeah, the lounge at the Palms, folks. What's new is they're pulling it apart. On Monday night, we had the very last performance of Santa Fe and the Fat City Horns, and this is one of the great local bands of all time in Las Vegas, dating its heritage is to 1975 in Las Vegas. There's Jerry Lopez's brother, Lenny, Tyreek Johnson up there on stage, and they have been the anchor of that room for about 8 years on Monday nights at about 10:30, and they're moving out. They closed it up, and they're going to be moving to Vamped on West Sahara next Monday night, same time. And I don't know what's going to happen with this venue. Matt Goss played in there. Frankie Perez played in there. Joey McIntyre from New Kids on the Block did a show in there. The Playboy Comedy Club has been in there. And it's been very popular, very appealing. And the only thing I can tell you now is that was the last actual formal show, and they're going to be doing a lot of renovation in that area at the Palms. This is part of a casino-wide food and beverage and entertainment overhaul. So we'll see what happens.
We'll have to stay tuned on that.
Stay tuned, absolutely.
All right, now let's talk of Phantom, the Las Vegas Spectacular. That show, of course, closed, but part of it at least kind of sort of lives on here.
Yeah, we have the Phantom of the Opera is coming back to Las Vegas for the first time since the Phantom Las Vegas Spectacular closed at Venetian. The full-length show is opening tonight at the Reynolds Hall at the Smith Center. There are many differences in this show. One is that the show that is in Las Vegas right now is the full musical, 2.5 hours with all the music in it. They boiled this show down to 90 minutes and cut the intermission for the Las Vegas audiences, and it moved a lot quicker.
Right.
This is the full deal with the intermission and everything. I've got a few friends who played in the Phantom version at the Venetian, including James Harvey, the violinist, who is a concertmaster, is back with this show. And my friends, we've got Beth Lano on French horn, and a number of other performers in Las Vegas who are returning to the stage. The chandelier falls on the stage now, not over the audience, if you saw the version at the Venetian.
Right.
And so that's running through June 11th. And it'd be interesting to see, for those who saw the original version at the Venetian, how this version plays out.
Okay. As always, this is the man in the know. You can catch his column called Cats Online anytime.
Cats!